哈利路亚，各位兄弟姐妹，大家晚上平安。
Hallelujah, a very good evening to all of you, brothers and sisters.
我们大家预备一颗清洁的心，来聚会敬拜我们天上独一的真神，主耶稣基督。
Let's prepare a pure and clean heart to worship our true God in heaven, the Lord Jesus Christ.
同心
Let
默
us
祷。
let's say a silent prayer.
阿门。奉主耶稣圣名开始晚上的聚会，
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we begin our evening service.
我们大家唱赞美诗第16首，
We sing hymn number 16.
敬拜天地主宰。
All hail the power of Jesus' name.
好，我们来一二三，耶稣圣名普天众经。天使一同归报，奉献冠冕大家行礼，尊他天地主宰，奉献冠冕大家行礼，尊他天地。主宰，无人蒙恩免罪永活，显明主心慈爱，颂扬耶稣世人救主，称他天地主宰。颂扬耶稣世人救主，称他天地主宰。世人都是主所创造，一本生出万道，都当崇拜耶稣基督。敬他天地主宰，都当崇拜耶稣基督。敬他天地主宰，现在圣徒早晚聚集。齐向耶稣跪拜，同声唱诗，同心欢乐，赞叹天地主宰。同声唱诗，同心欢乐，赞叹天地。主宰，我们这个月都是在家庭在线上来聚会，
We have been having our church services online throughout the month.
那感觉到像是使徒时代那些古圣徒常在店里在家里面聚会，
It felt like the ancient saints, the apostles, who have been worshiping God in their own homes in the olden times.
我们祈求神祝福与我们同在。
We ask the Lord God to bless us.
一起奉主的名同心祷告。
We pray in the name of Jesus in one accord.
哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名祷告。哈利路亚，感谢赞美主耶稣。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚。哦，哟，滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴，噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜滴滴滴滴滴滴，哦，滴滴滴滴滴滴，噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜，哟，滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴，哦，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜噜，哦，哟，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，滴噜，哦，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，滴哟，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，滴噜哟，噜噜噜噜噜，哦， 哈利路亚，感谢主耶稣，阿门。哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名，正道。
Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I speak.
主所亲爱的大家，主里平安。
Brothers and sisters, whom the Lord Jesus loves, peace be with you in the Christ.
靠着圣灵的帮助。
By the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们继续向家人说话。
We continue to speak to our family members.
是讲我们家里的事情。
With regards to the matters at home.
但愿我们的家能够更加圣洁，能够发出神荣耀的光辉。
With a wish that we are able to have a holier family, to be able to shine forth the glorious light of God.
这一段时间呢？我们从使徒行传看教会危机，就是看家里的危机。
In this period, we will spend some time to look at the Acts of the Apostles, regarding the crisis of Acts of the Apostles, and also the crisis at home.
其实就是在清除家里面的污秽，家里里面不圣洁的事情。
That is also in our effort to purify what is unclean and what is filthy in our homes.
好像古代的以色列民，守这个逾越节过后，马上就要遵。就要守这个除酵节。
Just as after the Israelites have kept the Passover feast, they will have to immediately hold observe the feast of the unleavened bread.
就是神交代，把家里一切有效的、污秽的、不干净的，全部要清除干净。
that is by the command of God that all that is unclean and all that is filthy must be purged and cleansed.
说实在的，我们真耶稣教会里面很久很久没有大扫除了。
But of course, when we look back to our own church, it has been a long time since we had our last spring cleaning.
那有一些个人自己在清洁自己是有的。
Some of us have taken our own initiative to clean up the church.
啊，透过这个使徒行传的教会危机呢，我们在大扫除，在清洗家里，清洗家里，让家干净。
From understanding the crisis in Acts of the Apostles, we take the opportunity to have a spring cleaning in our own homes, in our spiritual homes.
可是这会引起撒旦的嫉妒，撒旦的攻击，撒旦的不甘愿。
But that would also incur the jealousy and also the frustration of the devil, of Satan.
因为传道也有听到一些负面的消息，一些压力。
Because preacher has also personally been exposed to some negative pressure.
但是我们大家敬畏神的都知道，清洁家里的污秽，这是合乎神旨意的，也必须要做的。
But we all understand that in our process of cleaning and purifying our homes, this is something that must come to pass.
就好像保罗在圣经上说的，借着道把教会洗净。借着道就是我们讲的道理，我们读的圣经，借着道把家里洗除干净。
That's also what Paul has spoken, that we have to cleanse our homes and our church by the word of God.
也把自己的内心洗干净。
We are also cleansing our own hearts.
我们现在继续《使徒行传》第三章。
We continue to read on Acts of the Apostles, chapter 3.
那么这第三章里面，传道一准备了三个危机。
In this chapter alone, the preacher has prepared three crises.
第一个危机，我们上次有稍微谈到的，就是切腿的危机。
The first crisis we have briefly mentioned about it last time, the crisis of being lame.
那么一开始传道就提出一个问题。
I started with a question.
为什么圣灵降临的第一件神迹是医治切腿？
Why was it that after the downpour of the Holy Spirit, the first important miracle was healing of the lame?
这是一个重要的启示，重要的真理。
This turned out to be a very important revelation and important truth.
那第二个重点。
Secondly,
主耶稣警告我们，在启示录十一章警告我们。
The Lord Jesus have warned us.
启示录十一章警告我们。
In the book of Revelation, chapter 11.
没有进入圣所的，到最后没有进入到圣所里面去的，主耶稣说他不要了。
Those who do not manage to enter into the Holy of Holies, eventually in the sanctuary of the temple, they will be rejected by the Lord.
传道提出了这个圣殿区里面有四层，四个层面，四个进度。
The preacher has also elaborated on the four areas and layers in the Holy Temple of God.
第一层是外邦人的。
The first layer being the outer court of the Gentiles.
第二层是以色列人的。
The second layer being the court for the Jews, for the Israelites.
第三层是立位人或者祭司的。
The third court, the inner court, was for the priest and the Levites.
第三层，那第四层才是圣所，真正的进入神里面去，神的圣所里面。
And the innermost court, the fourth layer, is only the sanctuary of the Lord God, the Holy of Holies.
那主耶稣交代约翰说，如果没有在圣殿里面的，在圣所里面的，其他的不要量，因为把他们当作外邦人，把留给外邦人。
The Lord Jesus has instructed Elder John that he did not have to measure anyone out of the sanctuary of God or the Holy of Holies because they are not part of the temple.
所以今天圣灵来降临的重要工作，除了建立教会，就是要带领我们，帮助我们走到神里面，走到圣所里面去。
Therefore, we have to rely on the help of the Holy Spirit so that we're able to walk our way into the Holy of Holies.
所以他重要的工作，迫切的工作，就是要医治切腿的，让我们可以行走。
Therefore, the most important work of the Holy Spirit is for us to be healed from our lameness, so that we are able to walk ourselves.
这两个重点是上次讲过了。
These two important points I have already elaborated the last time.
那么我今天讲第三点这个第三个重点。
I'll talk about the third point.
哦，我们不要被沙滩上的脚印误解了、误会了。我们不是有一个故事说沙滩上的脚印吗？很感人的故事，有没有？
We have heard of a very touching story about the footprints in the sand. Let's
那
not
么
misunderstand this.
我们诗班呢、啊、也有做这一首歌，特别做这个沙滩上的脚印来唱啊。
If an choir has especially sung a hymn of by this title, Footprints in the Sand.
老师说这首歌呢，这个故事非常感人的，说明主耶稣的爱跟主耶稣的替我们承担很多的痛苦。
And of course, this is a very moving hymn where we hear of the story of the Lord Jesus bearing our burdens and our sufferings.
但是很多人听了这个故事被感动过后已经误解了这个故事了，它的真正的用意。
But too many of us have misunderstood the essence and the significance of this moving story.
讲严重就是政治偏差了，被骗了，被这个故事骗了。
And to make it worse, we have already been fooled by this beautiful story.
我为什么这样讲呢？
Why am I saying
因
this?
为大家都觉得主耶稣会抱我啊，主耶稣会背着我走啊，感谢神，神爱我啊。
We have been mistaken into thinking that the Lord Jesus will keep carrying us on his back and the Lord Jesus will still shower us with all his love
你
forever.
不要再误解这个沙滩上的脚印，或者被这个故事来欺骗你。
Do not misunderstand the story of the footprints in the sand.
主耶稣没有说他会背我们进天国的，从来没有，圣经从来没有这样讲，他也没有这样的运行，他也没有这样做的。
Neither the Bible nor Jesus have promised us that He will carry us through a journey all the way into heaven.
我们还小的时候，婴还需要父母抱，那是没错，因为婴还不会走路。
While we were still babies or infants, we will need our parents to carry us, that's right.
甚至特别情况不能够走的时候呢，或许耶稣会抱我们起来，但是不是永远把你抱在手上的，
And
会把
only in
你放在身上的，不是的。
Only in special circumstances that the Lord Jesus would still carry us on his back, but not all the time.
因为天国路要你自己走的，你一定要自己走的。
Because the journey to heaven is a road that you must tread on it yourself.
那圣经有没有这样讲呢？要自己走呢？
Has the Bible told us that we have to walk our own journey?
我们看这个启示录第七章。
Return to the book of Revelation, chapter 7.
启示录第七章，我们读13节到14节。
Revelation chapter 7, verse 13 to verse 14.
来一起读13节。
Verse 13.
1、2、3，长老中有一位问我说："这些穿白衣的是谁？是从哪里来的？"我对他说："我主，你知道。"他向我说："这些人是从大患难中出来的，曾用羔羊的血把衣裳洗白净了。"这里长老中有一位问约翰说："这些穿白衣的是谁？你知道吗？他们是从哪里来的？"他们是什么人？
One of the elders here asked John, "Do you know who these people are who are arrayed in white robes?"
然后呢，这里回答说，这些穿白衣的人啊，是从大患难中出来的。
And the answer is that these are the ones who come out of great tribulation.
他们都是经过大患难，经过患难的熬炼，自己走出来的。
They have been tried and tested through great tribulations, and they have walked their way out.
我们怎么知道他自己走呢？
How do we know that they have walked their own ways?
在原文从大患难中出来，原文是用主动词，主动词就是主动的自己走出来，主动的自己走出来。
In the original text, when the word "come out of the tribulation" is in a form of a very is in a form of active tense where they have to actively decide.
受患难已经够痛苦了。
Tribulations are already a huge suffering.
而且这里的患难是大患难啊，不是小患难，不是普通的患难，是很可怕的大患难。
And it is described here that it is not just any tribulation, but a great tribulation.
你看主耶稣有抱住他吗？主耶稣有背起他吗？
Do you see the Lord Jesus carrying them all the way?
在这个时候，每个人要自己走出来，主动的自己走出来。
At this circumstance, they have to actively make their own decision to come out of the tribulation themselves.
他们还要做第二件事情。
And they still have to do another thing.
他们要用羔羊的血把衣裳洗白了，洗净了。他们要主动的洗衣服。
They have to proactively wash their own robes in the blood of the Lamb.
在大患难中，在逼迫当中，在受苦当中，一要自己走，第二要继续的洗衣服，洗干净。
In times of great tribulation, very difficult sufferings, and first of all, they have to walk their own way, they have to come out of it themselves, and secondly, they have to wash their own robes.
然后到十五节的时候，我们就看到感谢主，他们已经走到神里面去了。
In verse 15, we can see, thank the Lord, they have walked their way to, before the throne of God.
你看，所以十五节。
Verse 15.
所以他们在神宝座前，昼夜在神的殿中侍奉他。那坐宝座的要用帐幕覆披他们，他们自己走走走走，不断的走，走到神的宝座面前，走到神里面去。他们走进去了，他们走进去了。
These people have been walking their own way on their own all the way to the, until they reach and arrived at the throne of God, and they're able to serve God day and night in the temple.
然后呢，他们穿着洁白的衣服，因为不断的洗衣服嘛，穿着圣洁洁白的衣服，在圣殿里面侍奉真神。
And they are dressed in white robes because they continuously wash their own robes and to worship the true God in the holy temple.
对，这个启示录这个七章十四节。告诉我们哦，主耶稣没有背着我们，你要自己走。
Therefore, in the book of Revelation, chapter 17, here from verses 14 onwards, we are able to see that the Lord Jesus has not been carrying you on his back all the time. Walk your way.
我们本来就已经够懒惰了，不努力了。
We have already been very lazy.
然后听了这个故事，听了这样的不断的这样说神的爱怎么样怎么样，我们更加放心了，更加不用努力呀。
And after listening to the story of footprints in the sand, and we think of the love of God, we are all rest assured to continue to be lazy.
我哭啊，我伤心啊，我跟耶稣说我很痛苦啊，我走不了啊，我很软弱啊，啊，耶稣就抱我起来了。
And you shed tears, and you say that you are sad, and you are depressed, and you will wait for the Lord Jesus to carry you on his back.
我现在慎重地告诉家人，绝对没有这样的事。
Allow me to.
因为你长大了，绝对没有这样的事，因为你是健康的人。
Allow me to seriously notify all of you, our family members. You are now a grown up, and there will be no such thing that the Lord Jesus will always carry you.
我现在还是 baby 啊，我刚刚生出来才两三天一两个月啊，除非你这样讲哦。
Unless you tell me that you are only a newly born infant for a few months.
那么主耶稣会很伤心哦。
Then probably the Lord Jesus will be sad to hear that.
你这样讲，他的心会流血。会痛苦。
His heart would even bleed.
因为你已经是洗礼信主几十年的老信徒了。
Because you're already an old member who has believed in Christ for many years and even a decade or more.
你跟主耶稣说我是婴孩，我需要抱抱。你主耶稣不是痛苦吗？听你这样讲。
If you were to tell Jesus that you are just a baby or an infant and I need him to carry you.
跟主耶稣说我是 baby 啊，主耶稣你抱抱我，你看主耶稣会不会抱我？我会给主耶稣打，给主耶稣鞭打。
If I were to say that to the Lord Jesus, and do you think that the Lord Jesus would carry me on his back? He would probably whip me up.
哦，所以你就知道为什么圣灵的第一件工作要使瘸腿的医治瘸腿，要让他自己走，医好他了，他就要走。
Now you understand the significance behind the miracle of healing of the lame after the downpour of the Holy Spirit, so that one is able to walk their own way and into the temple of God themselves.
弟兄姐妹，你自己要来聚会，自己要走来聚会，知道吗？不要一直人家叫你，不要一直人家打电话给你，不要一直人家用车来载你，你自己哦，要主动的走进教会，走进主耶稣的面前。
Therefore, brothers and sisters, please also take your own initiative to go to church and not to wait for someone to call you up or to fetch you from your house, but you have to take the initiative to walk your way to the church.
有一个做妈妈的向左右邻舍来夸耀，来夸口。
A mother has been bragging herself to her neighbors.
她说啊，每个孩子都是跌倒，都是受伤的，都有流血的。
And she said that every child will have his times to fall down and bleed.
我的孩子哦，从来没有跌倒，从来没有受伤的，从来没有流血的。
But she said that my child has never fallen down and has never bled before.
那是不可能的呀。
But that's not possible.
她说，难道他不学走路吗？婴孩学走路一定会跌倒啊。
For a baby,
婴孩学走路一定会跌倒的呀。
for an infant to start learning how to walk, and he would have to he would have to walk and fall.
他说我不给他走的，我一直抱在身上的，一直抱到他现在。
Then she explained that I never let him walk. I will always carry him in my arms.
所以孩子十几岁的还要抱吗？
So until the child is already 10 years old or older, would you still expect him to be carried in his in her arms?
你觉得这个是很光荣的事，很荣耀的事情呢，还是一种羞耻呢，还是一种痛苦呢？
Do you think that's something for you to be proud of, or rather to be ashamed of?
这个孩子怎么十几岁、二十岁还不会走路啊？为什么？
That your child still doesn't know how to walk properly at the age of 10 or even older.
因为妈妈从来没有给他走过啊，怕他跌倒啊，怕他受伤，怕他流血，从来不让他学走路啊。
Simply because the mother is overprotective and afraid that he would fall and bleed and hurt himself.
所以主耶稣用大患难，用各种患难磨练我们，走，学习走，继续的走，越走越坚强，越走就越有力量。
Instead, the Lord Jesus continues to train us and drill us and test us, try us through all tribulations so that we are all becoming stronger and stronger.
对，传道说，如果你对沙滩上的脚印很感动的，对不起了，我让你的梦破碎了，对不起了。
I'm just saying that I have to apologize that if you are moved by the hymn, footprints in the sand, I must tell you I'm sorry because that may not be the complete story.
那个是很特别、很特别、很偶尔的情形，可能会这样，很特别的情形，可能主耶稣会抱一抱。That
kind of a beautiful story where the Lord Jesus will always carry you on his back should only be special circumstances and not every time.
好，我们再讲第三章的第二个危机。We
continue to talk about the second crisis in chapter 3, Acts of the Apostles.
第二个危机就是在圣殿外面的危机。 人已经在圣殿区里面了，但是却还是在圣殿外面，叫做在圣殿外面的危机。The
second crisis I entitled the crisis of those who are standing outside of the holy temple.
我们怎么知道呢？
How do we know that?
你看第二节啊，
Verse 2.
有一个人生来是瘸腿的，天天被人抬来放在殿的一个门口，把他放在殿的门口，不是放在殿里面，殿的门口，殿的外面哦。
Now the certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried to the gate of the temple, which is outside of the temple.
对，这个人是没有进过殿里面的，知道吗？
This man has not entered into the temple.
哦，我们今天的信徒哦，看起来不少信徒在殿里面。
Today we look at the church and we see a lot of members inside the church.
其实却是在殿外面。
However, they are actually outside the church.
看起来好像在圣殿，已经在圣殿了，其实。 他没有进入圣殿里面。It
seemed as though they were inside the church, but they're actually outside.
就好像这个人这样咯。Just
like this man.
好像有些人已经聚会了，在厨房的呀。Some 常常来，就是常常在厨房，也不是轮到他煮饭，也不是他在有责任，他就是在厨房啊，就是都没有进来的呀，没有进来一起聚会的呀。
Some people spend most of their church services in the kitchen or in the dining area, although they may not have a duty to serve there, but they will still stay there.
有一些就在接待外面，接待处，不是他在做接待啊，他就是在外面做外面讲话呀，他不进来的呀。
And some people remain in the reception area, although the service has been ongoing, but he will rather stay there and have chit chat.
这种例子常常都会看到，常常都在发生。
These are all very common examples that we always say.
你说他有去到教会吗？ 你说他有去教会吗？
You say, can you say that he has not come to church?
他有去教会了， 他已经进到教会里面了。
He definitely did, and he entered into the church.
教会的接待处也好， 教会的厨房也好， 都已经在教会里面了， 教会的范围了， 已经在教会的范围里面了。
Whether he was at the reception area or in the kitchen, he's already in the church building.
他说他有去教会啊。
He has been going to church.
但是他没有进入到圣所里面去，那个敬拜神的那个地方，他没有进去。But
he has yet to enter into the Holy of Holies, the place where he truly has worship.
对，我今天要讲的第二个危机是，人在圣殿其实却是没有进去，在圣殿外面。The
second crisis that I want to talk about is that when one is in the church, but yet he is not in the Holy of Holies.
请看马太福音书十五章。
Turn to Gospel of Matthew chapter 15.
马太福音书十五章。
Gospel of Matthew chapter 15.
我们读八节跟九节。
We read verse 8 to verse 9.
来，一起读来。
Let's read verse 8.
这百姓用嘴唇尊敬我，心却远离我。他们将人的吩咐当作道理教导人，所以拜我也是枉然。主耶稣在讲，这些人已经在圣殿里面敬拜神了，已经在圣殿里面了。
Here the Lord Jesus already mentioned that these are the people who are already in the temple of God, worshiping God.
表面上是已经在教会里面，事实上主耶稣说他们根本不在教会里面，没有在圣殿里面。
But it is only on a superficial level that they are worshiping God in the temple, but in reality, they are not worshiping God. Because their heart is far from the Lord God, is far from the holy temple.
The Lord
said that their heart is far from Him, and He is, and in vain they worship Him.
不要说平常的聚会，连圣餐啊，这么重要的圣餐，心也不在耶稣上，主耶稣里面。
Not to mention normal services, they don't even place their heart in the Lord Jesus during Holy Communion.
那我们做家长的，我们做管理这个家庭的牧者，我们是不是应该提醒，是不是应该责备呢？因为这个事情太多了。
We as the guardians and the leaders of the church, shouldn't we have the responsibility to help them and to rebuke them.
简单说就是人在教会，心不在教会，人在敬拜主，心不在主耶稣身上。
Simply put, that they are physically in the church, but they are not spiritually in the church. They do not have the heart to worship God.
圣经常常说，在主耶稣里面，在基督里，在基督里。圣经常常都讲，我们在基督耶稣里。
The Bible always tells us that we should be in Christ, within Lord Jesus.
现在我们来检讨一下，我们到底是真的在耶稣基督里，还是在耶稣基督外面？
So we have to examine ourselves now whether we have been abiding in Jesus or outside of Jesus.
我们到底是两只脚都站在圣殿里面，还是两只脚仍然站在外面？
Are our feet right now standing inside the holy temple or outside of the holy temple?
又或者我们一只脚在圣殿里面，一只脚在圣殿在殿外面？
Or perhaps we have one foot in the temple and one foot outside the temple.
我讲这三种情形都有了，在我们教会里面的情形都有了。
The above three scenarios are real scenarios in our church.
有些人两只脚在圣殿里面。
Some people have both their feet planted in the church.
有些人两只脚在圣殿外面。
Some people plant their feet, both their feet outside the church.
有些人一只脚在里面，一只脚还是在外面。
Some people have one foot in the church and the other outside the church.
我们看诗篇122篇。
We turn to Psalm chapter 122.
诗篇122篇。
Psalm 122.
我们读一节跟二节。
We read verse 1 to verse 2.
你从这里看，我们的脚站在哪里？你注意看。
We look here to see where our feet are put.
来，一二三。人对我说，我们往耶和华的殿去，我就欢喜。耶路撒冷啊，我们的脚站在你的门内。这个大卫说，他听到有人说要到神的殿去，他就很高兴哦，要到神的殿去。
David here described that he would be overjoyed and glad when someone asked him to go to the house of God.
要到神的殿去就是还没有到咯，只是跟你讲我要去咯，我今天要去教会咯，我要到教会去咯，但是还没有到咯。
It also means that they have not entered into the house of God, they are just on their way.
可是到第二节的时候，我们看到他们这些要到神殿去的人，第二节的时候，已经他们的脚已经进圣殿里面了。我们的脚已经站在主啊圣殿的门里面了。
And verse 2 here that says that these people who have invited him to the house of God, their feet have already been standing within the gates of the temple of God.
所以我们看到这里第一节、第二节的信徒哦，不是用嘴巴讲的，他嘴巴讲他就有行出来，他就真的两脚坐走到教会里面去，走到神里面去。
And now we understand that these people in the verses 1 and 2, they do not just do lip service and they actually have trod their way with their own feet to the temple of God.
这个就是圣灵要帮助我们解决的危机了，走到神里面去了。
This is a crisis that the Holy Spirit would want to resolve with us.
所以要回答这个问题哦，我们每个人都要用虔诚、诚实的心、敬畏神的心来回答这个问题啊。
And to answer this question, we all have to have a God-fearing heart and a reverent heart to answer this.
这个问题就是我们真的心在教会吗？ 还是人在教会，心不在教会？ 我们要回答这个问题。
This very important question that we must all answer now, whether or not our heart is in the church while we are physically in the church.
或者我们一只脚在里面，一只脚在外面。
Or whether we have one foot standing outside the church and the other inside the church.
所以我们传道长职，一样要好好回答这个问题。
The same question will be posed to the preachers and the ministers of the church.
不要自以为是。
Do not be self-righteous.
我们做传道的，做长老、执事的，一定是在里面的咯。 不要自以为是。
Do not be mistaken that as the preachers or as the ministers that will always be in the gates of the church. No.
就好像这个彼得跟耶稣保证，我绝对不会出卖你，我绝对不会离开你，我绝对不会跌倒，绝对。就算有人跌倒，那是人家，我绝对不会。
Just as Peter was courageously, claiming to God, claiming to Jesus that he would never deny Jesus and never forsake Jesus.
就是一只脚在教会里面，一只脚还是在教会外面。
While his foot was standing, while one of his feet was standing inside the temple and the other standing outside.
就是我们是教会的传道，我们是教会的长老，我们是教会的执事，我们是教会的负责人、带领人、领导人。
But we are the preachers, the leaders, the deacons, and the person in, and the committee of the church.
所以我说这个问题是要用全诚实的心、敬畏神的心来好好回答，不要敷衍的回答，那是没用的。
That's why I said that this question must be answered with a full reverence and godly heart.
这个就是在圣殿外面的危机。
This is a crisis of standing outside the holy temple.
这个人虽然已经到了圣殿了，其实他是在圣殿外面。
Although this man had already arrived at the holy temple, but he was still outside.
那我们讲第三个危机。
The third crisis.
第三个危机是什么呢？
What is the third crisis?
第三个危机就是动机不纯的危机，信耶稣或者来教会动机不纯洁的危机。The
crisis of having an impure intention in believing in Christ.
就好像这个人，这个瘸腿这样的。Just
like this lame man.
他来教会，来圣殿，不是要来敬拜神的，他绝对不是要来敬拜神的。This
lame man came to the holy temple not to worship God.
这里说他是要求进圣殿的人给他钱。
But here it tells us that he was there to ask for alms from those who entered the temple.
第三节，他真的是像进圣殿的人在求啊，给我钱啊，给我周济啊，给我一些钱，他真的是这样求，就这样讨啊。And
it's what in verse 3 we are actually seeing how he was begging and asking for alms.
那到第五节，他还一直在看作彼得、约翰进圣殿的人，希望从他们身上得到好处啊，得到他要的好处啊。
And it's in verse 5 that this man was actually giving attention to Peter and John and expecting to receive something, some benefits.
对，我们很清楚，从这里看到第三个危机，就是我们虽然来教会，虽然来来圣殿，但是动机不纯洁，动机不纯的危机。
It is very clear to us that this is a crisis of having impure motive or intention when we come to worship God.
我要讲的是，这个人来圣殿的动机。 不纯洁，连那些带他来的、抬他来的那些人的动机也不纯洁。But
I would like to elaborate further that not just this man who is lame, who had an impure intention, but those who carried him to the gate of the temple are also have a they also have impure intention.
第二节说，那些他天天被人抬来，就是放在美门那边，希望人家给他钱呢。 那个人本身也希望人家给他钱，抬他来的人、带他来的人也希望人家给他钱，所以这两种人的动机都不纯洁，来教会的动机都不纯洁。Verse
2 suggests to us that this man who is lame had been carried to the beautiful gate, and he had an impure intention to get money. And even those who carried this lame man would also have this kind of intention to profit from this.
今天好好思考，我们今天到教会来要做什么？ 我们今天到教会去要做什么？
Therefore, we have to examine ourselves. What exactly is our motive coming to church?
我们到底要得到什么？在教里面得到什么？
What kind of benefits are we asking to receive?
再来，我们带亲戚朋友到教会，我们带朋友到教会，我们带他们来是让他们要让他们得到什么？
Even as we invite our friends and relatives to the church, and what kind of a benefit do you do? Are we expecting them to receive and ourselves to receive?
他本人 要思考，带他来的人也要检讨。
The people who are invited to the church, they themselves have to examine themselves for their intention, and we who brought them in, we also have to examine our intentions.
我常常听到有的人，哎，来我们教会啊，我们教会有的吃啊，去完会就有的吃了，你不用去，不用去烦恼午餐啊。有的吃的。
So often do I hear that people are inviting people because there's good lunch at our church and you don't have to worry about your food.
聚会会很有团契啊，哦，很多节目的。
And after the service, we have a lot of programs lined up for you.
哎，你来我们教会了，我们教会啊，下个月啊，我们下个月我们计划要去旅行啊，要去台湾啊，要去哪里啊？我们一起去啊，我们教会有这种的节目啊。
And come to our church because we have a very special program. We are traveling to Taiwan, and this is something that you can join us for.
有时候我们有什么节目，我们有送礼物哇，我们教会有送礼物啊，你来啊！我这些我都亲耳听到的。
Or perhaps there's a gifting ceremony, and you will receive gifts from our program. These are the things I hear with my own ears.
难道你带亲戚朋友来是要他们得到这些东西吗？
Is that your
会让他们很快很高兴吗？
Are these the things that you want your friends and relatives to receive by inviting them to church?
如果是这样哦，你们两个人都不动机都不纯，那个人来的也不纯，你带他来的你也不纯洁。
If that's the case, and your the intention of you and also your friends and relatives whom you brought are not pure.
为什么这样子？
Why am I saying this?
第三章第二节就是这样的事情啊，你看清清楚楚啊，两个人都动机不纯啊。
Because that has also already been mentioned here in chapter 3, verse 2, both parties do not have a pure intention.
请注意这个人切腿的哦，他所在的位置，他站的位置是什么地方，知道吗？
Do you know what was this place where the lame was being put?
美门呢，这个美门在左不远呢，就是奉献财物的地方。
Not far away from the beautiful gate is the place where they offer the sacrifices and their possessions.
要奉献的人呢，必须需要经过这个美门，啊，才到奉献的地方去。
People who want to make their offerings have to pass through this beautiful gate.
所以这个人跟那个抬他来的人，他们都已经计算好了，已经策划好了，已经想好了，知道要站在哪里收获更多，讨得更多。
Therefore, it is clear to imply to us that this lame man and the people or the person who have been carrying him to the beautiful gate had this all planned out and like a scheme.
那么他们呢？这些人呢？也利用正在敬拜神的人，那些爱神的人，利用他们的爱心来得到好处，来给他们利用教会了。我们说利用教会了。
And this is simply put, these are the people who are trying to utilize the church for their own benefit.
如果真的是这样，那真的是，这是个危机，动机不纯的危机了。
If that's truly the case, then this is the crisis of having impure intentions.
这种动机不纯哦，纵使你洗礼过后哦，你都不能够长大，你也不能够荣耀神，你的生命也没有办法成长的，因为你的动机不纯洁。
If you have been carrying this kind of impure intention and motive, although you have already been baptized, then you will never grow because your heart is not pure.
所以你看得到啊，有些教会没有关，稍微没有注意到他，稍微没有给到他要的，他一直在骂呀，他一直在埋怨呢、啊。他这个是有背景的，只是你没有留意到他，或者你给不到他，他就是在发脾气、啊。这个是有背景的，他的动机的问题啊，他当初信耶稣的动机啊。
Which is why you find people who are always complaining when things have been given to him or her less, and that's because he has this background that he had always got this impure intention.
所以借助这个第三章的第三个危机，我们重新来思考，大家一起来检讨。
Through the third crisis in chapter 3, we re-examine ourselves on this matter.
第一，我为什么要信耶稣？
Firstly, why do I believe in Jesus?
我为什么要接受洗礼？
Why have I received baptism?
为什么要进入真耶稣教会？
Why do I join the true Jesus church?
思考这个问题。
We have to examine ourselves on these questions.
再来，我们当圣职人员的，我为什么要当执事？我为什么要当长老？我为什么要当传道？
And for those who hold office in the ministry of the church, why do I want to become a preacher or a minister? Why is that?
我们先来讲几个真实的事。
We'll talk about a few true stories.
就是动机不纯洁。
Of people having impure motives.
有一次在见证会的时候，有一个负责人哦，教会负责人，他起来做见证，他出来做见证。
There was a testimony session, a witnessing session where a person in charge of the church testified.
那个智慧你快一点，我时间不多了。那么他一开始就讲，我对不起主啊，我对不起教会啊。
He started with, I'm sorry to the church, I'm sorry to God.
他为什么对不起主？为什么对不起教会？
And why was he apologetic? Why was he sad? What was he saying sorry?
他已经在教会当负责人当了整十年了。
He had been the person in charge of the church for the past decade.
他说我骗教会，我骗了主耶稣。
He said, I have cheated Christ, I have cheated the church.
大家听到他的开场白这样讲，吓到了，大家都被他的话吓到了。
Everyone who heard this was taken aback.
他到底骗教会什么？他到底骗什么？
What exactly did he lie about?
他说我根本就不相信耶稣。
He told us that he did not believe in Jesus.
一直到好多年后，整十年后，他才悔改，他才认真的去信主耶稣，接受主耶稣的福音。
It was only after as long as 10 years, only then I repented and truly accepted the gospel of Jesus.
因为他要讨好他的女朋友，他的当时的女朋友。就是我们教会的姐妹，他要讨好她，要让她高兴，要让她答应嫁给他，他什么都答应，洗礼什么都 OK， 什么都完全的顺服。
Initially, he only agreed to be baptized and to accept Christ simply because he was trying to win the heart of his girlfriend, who was our church sister back then.
动词是结婚过后，洗礼过后，他还是要讨好他的太太，让他太太感受到他是很爱教会的，是很热心的。其实他心里根本不相信主耶稣是救主，耶稣的宝血，他完全不相信。
Even after his baptism and also their marriage, he continued to please his wife, but although he did not believe in the salvation grace of the Lord Jesus through his blood.
他不讲出来，谁知道他的心是这样？谁知道？
If he had not testified about this, no one would know about this intent.
还选他做教会负责人，就是领导教会的呀。
He was even been elected by the church as a committee member.
两个字，这多严重！一个不信主耶稣的人，却在带领主耶稣的教会，带领弟兄姐妹。
You can only imagine how severe it is that a person who doesn't believe in Christ leading the church.
对我们就会很多问题的，你知道吗？很多很多严重的问题的。
That will result into a lot of a series of serious problems.
我们都一直把它盖住，一直盖住，当没事，也假装看不到这种事。
We have all been trying to sweep this under the carpet, and we try to pretend that we didn't see it.
感谢主，他会做见证，就是他已经悔改了啦。
But we thank the Lord Jesus, the fact that he was able to testify about this, he had already repented.
第二件事。
Second event.
有人信主洗礼是为了得一张纸，得到一张纸。
Some people believed in Jesus Christ, in order to gain a piece of certificate.
什么叫做得到一张纸？
What does that mean to gain a piece of paper?
就是洗礼主啊。
That's to gain that baptism certificate.
洗礼这个就是一张纸而已嘛，就是一张纸而已啊，几个字在上面啊，签个名这样而已啊。
The certificate of baptism is only a piece of paper with a signature on it.
洗礼过后，来教会那个洗了洗教礼，他就走掉了。他拿到那个洗礼证书，他就走掉了。从此以后不来教会，从来就没有再踏过教会一步了。
And as soon as he has received this certificate of baptism and foot washing, and he had disappeared from the church.
我们去找他，打电话给他，他都不见了，不接电话，不见面。
He declined all our calls, and he was nowhere to be found.
后来他不耐烦了，他就讲了：我已经得到你们的洗礼证书这一张纸了，我得到了，我为什么还要去？我就是为了这个文凭呢，这个洗礼证书来证明啊。
Finally, he was frustrated from our constant calling, and he told us that I have already received what I wanted. It was that certificate, and I don't have to come to church anymore, should I?
那你要来干什么？要证明什么？
Then what kind of what are you trying to prove with this certificate?
教会他在玩弄基督派教，基督的教会。
He was trying to make a fool out of Christian churches.
因
为他到过好多几十间教会去受洗去拿证书了，他已经有几十张证书了啊。
Because he has been going to different churches, different denominations to be baptized and to get this whole folder of certificates.
好像是他的战利品哦，我胜过了，我玩弄你们，我胜过了，你们都被我玩弄。
It was as though this was his prizes for successfully fooling all the churches.
他不讲出来，知道这种动机，谁知道呀？
If he had not testified about this himself, how would we ever find out about his true intention?
还有不纯洁的动机是什么
？So what are other impure intents?
这些是为了来做生意的啦。
This is another case of doing it for business profit.
然后教会有很多几百个信徒嘛，卖这一个有可以做生意，可以卖产品。
Since the church has a huge membership, it is a good place for anyone to sell their product.
保险的呀。
This person was in the insurance industry.
因为你要用精神来翻译快一点。这些都是为了要做生意的呀。
These are the people who are trying to earn a profit.
这个动机就不纯洁了，他也洗礼了，他为了要做生意啊，动机。
And he had an impure intent because he also came for a baptism.
还有就是为了一块地来受洗，来进入真耶稣教会。
And it was only for a piece of a benefit that he agreed to baptism.
另外一个 case。
Another case.
我们教会洗礼会给地吗？有没有搞错？如果会给地，几多人都要来真耶稣教会啊？他是为了一块地。
This person who came for baptism in order to gain a piece of land, is there such a thing?
原来死的时候要买一下那个墓地啊。
That is in order to gain a piece of land for his burial after his death.
因为他的太太是我们教会信徒，那他死后要跟太太葬在一起。
Simply because his wife is a church sister, and he wanted to be buried next to his wife when they both died.
那么那个坟场管理人说不可以啊，你一定要基督徒，一定要有洗礼证，所以要有教会签名、教会证明才可以啊。
But the graveyard, the funeral office or grave office did not agree because he has to be a Christian in order to be buried in this.
我要这样要证明很简单，那就洗礼啊，那很简单嘛，洗礼我又不会损失什么，那就洗啊。
And which is why he said that it is no big deal. I can simply baptize for this matter.
这些我讲的都是真真实实在我们教会发生的事，真真实实的事情。
These things that I mentioned are real events, are true stories.
然后他们是我们教会的人，所以动机不纯哦，搞到教会很多问题啊。他们都不是要信耶稣的，他们也不是要爱教会、爱主耶稣的，好多的问题就是这些信徒不成熟的信徒，动机不纯洁的信徒。
These are also the members of our church, and many problems have arisen because of this kind of impure motives and intention when they first got baptized.
所以我们要悔改咯，当时的动机不纯，我们现在要悔改呀，要归回正确去。让我们的动机回归正确去。
Which is why we ought to repent now, because we have to purify ourselves from the evil or from the impure intents that we earlier had.
这刚才那几个例子都是讲信徒啦，都是信徒的 example。
The few examples that I quoted just now was all from our own members.
我现在来讲我们圣职人员的例子，动机侍奉主做圣工的动机不纯洁的例子。
Now I would like to talk about our ministers in the church who have impure intentions in serving the true God.
那么有一个负责人，他做一个梦，教会的负责人。
There was a person in charge of our church who had a dream.
他看到有一个大舞台啊，大戏台啊，有些人在上面不断的在表演啊，舞台就是拿来表演的嘛。
He saw a great stage where there are performers performing.
那很多人去看啊，很多人去看他表演啊，看这些人表演。
And many people came to this performance to watch him perform.
人多到那个马路哦，都起了很多灰尘啊，因为人在走啊，在脚车啊、摩托啊、跑啊，那整个路都是天空都是灰尘啊，灰灰蒙蒙的。
It was so crowded that people are rushing here and there, and the road was full of dust from all the hustles and bustles.
那他也想要去看啊。
So he was curious to have a look.
要到那边之前就听到很多的喊叫声啊，拍掌声啊，那些台上很热烈在表演啊。
As he was approaching, he heard a lot of applause and loud claps because people were cheering and screaming.
可是前面挤满的人啊，他没有路再进去啊，他就看到旁边有一条小路，他就走从小路过去。
And since the way in front of him was already blocked with all the crowds, and he had to find another way.
那个小路是通到戏台的后面的，舞台的后面。
Smaller road to inside the stage was from the back of the stage, from backstage.
那个舞台后面也有一个很漂亮的建筑物。
And even at the backstage, there was a beautiful building.
那他就走进去。
He walked into this building.
走进去那个大门那边写作金棺材，金棺区就是放金棺材的地方，放棺材的地方。但是那些棺材是金子做的，金子打造的棺材叫做金棺材。
As he entered into the building, he found this sign written as the golden coffin.
哇，那些棺材很飘，所谓的飘就是黄金嘛，那个照到都是闪闪发光哦，都金光闪闪，整个放棺材的地方都是金光闪闪。
This coffin actually looked very exquisite because it was shining in gold.
但在怎样金光闪闪都是棺材啊，有点恐怖啊。
Although it was so exquisite and so beautiful, but it was still a coffin.
那个棺材有大有小。
These coffins came in different sizes.
一层一层的这样叠起来，很多啊，很多金棺材。
There are many of them being stacked upon each other.
那突然间呢，就有个黑衣人出现，突然间出现站在他的旁边。
And suddenly a man in black appeared next to him.
那么这个黑衣人呢，自己这样说，自己这样回答。
And this man dressed in black told him this.
这些金棺材都是给外面那些表演的人预备的。
He said that these golden coffins are all prepared for the performers out there.
表演越热烈的，掌声越大声的，他的棺材就越大，金棺材就越大。
The greater the applause these performers receive, the bigger the golden coffin this performer will get.
这是一个教会负责人跟我讲的，他做的梦。
This is the dream that a person in charge of our church told me.
我相信他也正在听这个见证。
And I think that he's actually listening to this sermon now.
他当时跟我讲，他很害怕，他非常害怕。
He told me that he was very afraid at that time.
因为他怕自己也是其中一个在舞台上表演的人，在教会的舞台那边表演。
He is afraid that he would happen to be one of the performers at a stage of the church performing in the church.
本来教会是一个敬拜神的地方，是个服侍神的地方，变成一个舞台，一个大舞台，给那些甚至人员那些上台的人在那边表演啊，大家都尽情去表演啊。
Now the church is meant for the worship of the holy God, and it has been used as a stage to perform by many ministers who stand up at the pulpit.
表演很注重的就是台下人的掌声跟支持，非常看重这个，现在非常在意这个掌声跟支持度。
And what is important for these performers is the applause and the support that they get from the audience.
所以他们怎么敢去得罪信徒？怎么敢去讲那些圣洁的道理？怎么敢去讲这种悔改的道理？
So how can they dare to speak up against the members and to speak on the sermons which lead to repentance?
纵使讲也是玩一个道啊，讲的不懂在讲什么，讲神也没有讲那一种。
Even if they try to speak on these sermons of repentance, they will probably beat around the bush and it will lose its efficacy.
不是他不会讲责备的道理，不是，是他不愿意太清楚的去责备，他不愿意这样做，会得罪人啊。
They are unwilling to speak on these sermons regarding repentance, but it is rather that he is unwilling to offend people.
也许他会说，难道我们讲道理就要责备人吗？
He will probably argue with you that should we always rebuke people during our sermons?
那你就自己多看圣经了吧，看主耶稣怎么样讲，看保罗怎么样讲，看先知们怎么样讲道理。
Then I advise you to read the Bible and look at how the apostles and Jesus himself spoke their sermons.
那做错了，教会这么多污秽的事，这么多不合乎真理的事，难道还要称赞他吗？你不责备，难道你还要支持他吗？
if our members have already done wrong, and are we still about to advise them or to encourage them to do worse?
这个就是动机不纯啊，释放动机不纯。
This is about an impure intention in worshiping God and serving God.
这些都带来了我们教会今天的哦不圣洁的问题，教会污秽的问题，教会被魔鬼攻击的问题。
This has all led to the problems that our church becoming unholy and becoming attacked by the devil.
那最后一个见证呢，是对那些圣职人员讲的金棺材，记得。金棺材等座要给你，金子做的棺材等座要给你。
And the last testimony about the golden coffins are spoken to the ministers that these golden coffins are prepared for some of you who are performing.
啊，感谢主，我们第三章的危机，我们就讲这三个危机就好了。
On this chapter three, we will talk on these three crises.
当然还有其他危机在里面的。
There are of course other crises in this.
我们来唱诗。
Let's sing hymn.
唱诗158首
We sing him 158.
走在主路上
Walking on the King's Highway.
158
1, 2, 3
我看沙漠如神的缘由因为走在主路上主是喜乐如百花锦绣因为走在主路上这里有主路可以往无忧愁亦无惊慌光明强如太阳照亮因为走在主路上，主你降临，种子皆发芽。因为走在主路上，生命泉源永流处处江。因为走在主路上，这里有主路可以往。无忧愁亦无惊慌光明强如太阳照亮因为走在主路上不必惧怕门首已独身因为走在主路上宿命歌唱心中皆无恙因为走在主路上这里有主路可以往无忧愁亦无惊慌光明强如太阳照亮因为走在主路上，走在主路上。那我们一起来祷告。
We shall now say a prayer.
那祷告中继续为我们真耶稣教会来祈祷。
In our prayer, we continue to intercede for the True Jesus Church.
这是神的家。
This is the house of God.
也是我们的家。
It is also our home.
就是为我们的家来祷告。
We pray for our homes.
也为自己祷告了。
And we also pray for ourselves.
借助就是那个病毒的事情。
And we also intercede for the pandemic.
但愿大家能够改变生活的方式，改变一些属世的观念、态度。
But also with the wish that we are able to change our understanding of our usual perception of our lives.
除了努力工作，要生活吃饭，要养育孩家庭，我们更多的心思进放在神身边，放在神的心身上，我们走到神的生命里面去。
Other than toiling and working hard for your livelihood and for your family, all the more we should work hard for to draw close to God.
然后除了自己要走，那也要常常洗衣服，把衣服洗干净。
Not only will you need to walk your way in your journey of faith, you have to also wash your own robes.
一直走到神的面前。
until you reach the presence of God.
来起奉主的名祷告。
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告。哈利路亚，感谢赞美主耶稣。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利
哈利路亚，感谢主耶稣，阿门。
这里有主路可以往，无忧愁亦无尽慌，光明强如太阳照亮，因为走在主路上。这里有主路可以往，无忧愁亦无尽慌，光明强如太阳照亮， 因为走在主路上。阿门。感谢主耶稣，阿门。
那你关声音了。
好，大家平安啊，再见。
Peace be with you.
主